Hi everyone, welcome to this getting started tutorial about the Syncfusion Blazor drop-down menu. In general, you can use the drop-down menu to toggle between the different contextual overlays that display the list of action items. You can also display both the text and images together on these action items. You will see some of its built-in features, such as adding and positioning icons, setting different pop-up menu positions, and adding separators. I will also explain how to customize the pop-up menu items and navigate to other web pages when a specific action item is clicked. To explore the other features available in Syncfusion Blazor drop-down menu, refer to the website link shown in the above YouTube card. First, I will start with the Blazor application creation process. For this, I need to make sure the .NET Core SDK's latest version is installed in my machine. I should also have Visual Studio Code or Visual Studio 2019 installed to create a Blazor application. In this tutorial, I am going to create a new Blazor app. So, let me open Visual Studio 2019 and create a new project from the project dashboard. From the list of project templates, I choose Blazor WebAssembly app and click Next. Here, I name my project Blazor drop-down button and click the Next. After that, click the Create button with the default target framework to complete the project creation. The project has been created and is ready to use. If you want to know more about Blazor WebAssembly apps and how to add Syncfusion components to one, then you can click on the video link shown in the above YouTube card. Now, let's add the Blazor drop-down menu component. First, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor split buttons NuGet package in my application. I open the NuGet package manager by right-clicking the project and choosing Manage NuGet Packages. Then, I search for Syncfusion Blazor split buttons in the Browse tab and install it in my project. Once the installation is completed, I navigate to the imports.razor file, and here, I add the Syncfusion Blazor split buttons namespace. Now, I can start using the Blazor drop-down menu component in any of the components available in the Pages folder. Next, I open the program file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then, I register the Syncfusion Blazor service by calling the method @SyncfusionBlazor within this main method. Also, I should register the valid license key in my application. So, let me register the trial license key by using the RegisterLicense method. I then need to define the CSS for the Blazor drop-down menu. I navigate to the index.html file to reference the CSS file from the installed Syncfusion Blazor package. Okay, the configuration steps are done. Now, let me add the Blazor drop-down menu. So, I open the index.razor page, remove the default code, and include the tag SF drop-down button. Then, I need to add content for the drop-down menu, so, within this code section, I define the variable button content and assign the value options to it. Now, I will assign this variable button content to the content property. I want to display 5 options in the drop-down menu, so first I need to define the drop-down menu items tag, which is of type array and can accept n number of drop-down menu item definitions inside it. So, I will define 5 drop-down menu item tags to add 5 menu items. For these menu items, I need to set the display name. Therefore, I will define the property text and set appropriate string values to it. Now, I am going to run this example. Looking at the output page, the drop-down menu component is displayed with the content options and menu items, edit, delete, mark as read, like, and share. You can notice that the drop-down menu items are displayed continuously. If I would like to separate those options, then I need to use the property separator. Now, I am planning to display the separator after the first 2 options. For that, I will define another drop-down menu item definition within this drop-down menu items tag. Then, I need to define the property separator and set its value as true. Also, I am going to display a drop-down menu at the center of the output page, so I will add a division section here and define custom style for it. When you look at the drop-down menu now, the separator is shown after 2 options. Now, I will show you how to add icons to the drop-down menu. First, I need to define the property icon CSS and set appropriate class names to it. Within this style section, I will define a font face with a specific SRC path and name its font family as menu icons to access the menu font icon for this drop-down menu at the application level. Then, to the class names that are assigned to the icon CSS property, I will now assign the appropriate content value to access the menu icon. And now, you can see in the output page, the drop-down menu is displayed with an options icon. Similarly, you can also add icons for menu items. Here, you can see that the button icon is placed at left side of the button content. If you want to change the icon position, then you may need to use the property icon position. Now, I am going to change the icon position to the top by defining the property icon position and setting its position as top. Look at the output page now, and the icon is placed at the top of the button content. Next, I will show you how to navigate to another web page when an action item is clicked. I am going to navigate to a Twitter page while clicking the share menu item. Therefore, I need to define the property URL with the appropriate link. Also, I am going to display a drop-down menu icon on the left side of the button content, so I will set its icon position as left. Looking at the output page now, when I click the share option, the current page navigates to the Twitter login page. By default, the drop-down menu pop-up items are listed vertically. If I want to list those items horizontally, then I need to add a custom style to the CSS class property. Within the style section, I will define the custom class and add some CSS styles to it. Then, I define the property CSS class and assign this defined class to it. Also, I want to display list items without a separator, so let me remove the separator item from the menu items. Looking at the output page now, when I click the drop-down arrow, the drop-down menu pop-up items are displayed horizontally. By default, you can see the drop-down arrow is shown. If I want to hide this drop-down arrow, then I need to add a predefined class, e-hide, to the CSS class property. So now, you can see in the drop-down menu that the arrow icon is hidden. Next, I will show you how to disable an item from the menu using the onOpen event. First, I need to define drop-down button events inside the Blazor drop-down menu code. Then, I will add an onOpen event with the appropriate event handler. Now, I define the event handler disable list item, which receives an argument of type before open close menu events args. I am going to disable the delete item from the drop-down menu, so let me define the variable list item state of type boolean. Next, within this disable list item method, I will set the list item state value as not list item state, which means the list item state value will be true because, by default, a false value will be set to the boolean variable if a value is not assigned to it. Now, to disable the delete item, I need to define the property disabled within this menu and assign this variable list item state to it. Looking at the output page now, you can see in the drop-down menu component that the delete item is disabled. The SyncFusion Blazor drop-down menu also supports other native events like opened, closed, onClose, and so on. Finally, I will show you how to disable the drop-down menu. I just defined the property disabled and set its value to true. See the output page now. The drop-down menu is disabled. Now, let me quickly recap what we have seen so far. We have seen how to create a Blazor project using Visual Studio 2019 and add a SyncFusion Blazor drop-down menu component in a WebAssembly app. We have seen how to set icons and how to add separators and events to the drop-down menu component. Finally, we have seen how to navigate to another web page, as well as how to display the drop-down menu items horizontally. If you would like to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Blazor products through our community license. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.